Snipping Tool is a screenshot utility that can be used even on older versions of Microsoft Windows. With this tool, we can easily take screenshots of an open window, rectangular areas, a freeform area or a screen.
The scissor-cut pieces can then be annotated using a mouse or tablet. It can be stored as an image file NGIF or JPEG file, or an MHTML file, or sent by email.
The snipping tool allows basic image editing of photos or cropped images with different colored pencils, eraser, and highlighter.
Type the name of the application in the start menu to open the snipping tool. If you have used it before, its icon will appear in the menu when you type the first letters.
Now, we open the application with the scissors icon whose name appears in full.
The program opens immediately with a very simple basic interface.
We can freely move the application window wherever we want on the screen.
Meanwhile, information was shared recommending a more advanced version of the software, Snip and Sketch.
We will prepare content training on this topic in the future.
Now, let's get to know the interface of the current program without wasting time. The mode setting is right in front of us. With this setting, you have the option to select screen capture mode, full screen, or a rectangular area, or free choice area.
When we click full screen in mode,
it automatically selects the entire screen,
so we get an instant full screen excerpt.
This time we will try the rectangle mode to create a new screenshot.
Once activated, we drag while holding down the left mouse button to create a rectangular area, and as soon as we stop pressing the button, the selected area will be quoted. Our next mode choice is the free choice field excerpt.
When the cursor symbol turns into scissors, we draw the boundaries of the defined area as if we were drawing an empty space with a pencil.
Once our area has been cropped, we can use the pen and highlighting tools to make basic edits, place footnotes, create shapes and drawings.
After showing the highlight pen, we can look at the special pen tool and its settings. In the settings section, we have settings like color, shape and thickness.
The other basic tool is the eraser. With the eraser tool, we can selectively erase text and drawings that we have created with the pen or highlighting tool.
Next to the mode option, there is a delay setting where we can set the delay time for the snipping. The save icon in the form of a floppy disk is actually a shortcut option also available in the program menu.
Under the file menu, there are options such as save, forward, save as, and new quote, which can be found in almost all programs. The save or save as options allow us to save the snipping image, NGIF or JPEG file, or as an MHTML file.
Since we use the snipping tool so often, we can pin it to the taskbar. And create and save a screenshot in another rectangle mode.
In the snipping tool options section, there are some general settings that you can change according to your preferences, which we will continue to use as usual.
If there is a result we are not satisfied with when we take a screenshot, we do not have to save it. We can try again or as many times as we want.
With the new snipping option, we can even cancel it with the cancel option when the snipping is in active mode. When the snipping tool is open, pressing Ctrl plus print screen as a hotkey puts snipping into active mode. Let's take one last screenshot, save it and end this tutorial here.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.